that church. The starting phase of the building project begun in late 1200th century and were introduced a couple years later. In the middle of 1200th century, the church was fully built, and at the time the archbishop were buried in the core. They even reconstructed the church ceiling from wood to brick in the late 1200s. This church has not come through the centuries without changing. They changed a lot of things. The corridors were different, the cross and the nave were increased in height. The stained glass is generally from the 17th century, but one should be noted. The image above the entrance in the arched arch is a Triumph cricket fox, a Swedish work. The figure of Christ is from about 1500. The Triumph Crusher has been manufactured in Sweden around the year 1500, while the cross is newly created. The term Triumph Crucifix denotes the triumph of resurrected Jesus won over death. The crucifix is located by the triumphal arch, that is, in the transition between the core and the longhouse. The preacher is from 1647 and shows Jesus as a savior of the world. The chair is considered a work by the artist Claes Hebel, active at Vengarn Castle.
Stolof Church is a church in Sigtuna. It is located to the west of the Church of Mary, in the eastern outskirts of the old town. The church has a building history strongly similar to the nearby St. Per Church. They are approximately contemporary. Around 1100, the central tower, a cross and cross shape were built. At a later stage, however, the longhouse was added, which was built with a reduced length. Right next to the churchyard there is a source, probably associated with the cult of the patron saint Olof the Holy. In investigations in the summer of 2005 in St. Olof, archaeologists found deeply under the floor the foundation of an older stone church. Since 2015, the ruin has been blocked off due to falling bricks. St. Olof Church is well preserved and is alike the St. Peter Churchyard. Aside from the tower above the crossroad, it is completely different from the predecessor. St. Olof has been linked to the cult of the Norwegian saint King Olav the Holy. Olav Haraldsson, called the Holy or St. Olof in Norwegian, Olaf the Saint, who lived around the year 1000. St. Olaf was a king of Norway, and in the nation he is the nation of the saint. In the early 1000, he traveled several times to Sigtuna. Olaf was a successful Viking in the younger years. He raided Lake Mälaren in the Baltic Sea and around Denmark's coast. Olaf became the Nordic region's first and most popular saint. South of the corridor there is a well. It is possibly an old sacrificial source which had been put together with the Olof legend. The sacrificial sources were subject to cold traditions and they were offered coins and objects of value. The water of a sacrificial source was considered to be a medical capacity, and you drank it and used it to command sick people. The well has been overhanged and communicated with the shore via an opening down the floor. A shrine of the St. Olof relics might stand in the front of the altar. The church St. Olof was burnt down 1187 by Vikings who raided Sigtuna.
This is one of the earliest stone buildings in Sweden, the ruin of St. Peter's Church. It was built as early as the end of the Viking period, in the late 11th century, when Sigtuna already had existed as a town for about 100 years. Most of the buildings were small houses built out of wood. There were no stone buildings and the larger churches that were affected must have had a powerful impact on people. We don't know who built the church, but we think it might have been ordered by the king himself. In a very short time, this must have meant a tremendous change for the town's population. We think there may have been a thought behind this dynamic period of building churches, the ambition to imitate the heavenly Jerusalem, a town with many churches and sacred rituals and processions.
St. Lars church ruin. This church in Sigtuna with the least remains. The church was extended to the east and to the north. The south part was under a long time used as an armory. Under the Viking age, the Vikings came and burned the church to the ground. Only half of the church was still standing. After repair, the church was used as a school. 1658 was the year when the church burned for the last time and became the ruin we know. St. Lars Church has been mentioned that it was the city church. The only remains was the west tower. There are still questions about this ruin.